This is Dancehall Cyaan Done with DJ GQ on Bob Marley's Tuff Gong Radio, SiriusXM.
GQ, let him know.
And this is DJ GQ, and you're listening to Dancehall Cyaan Done on Bob Marley's Tuff Gong Radio.
And it's on SiriusXM Channel 19. In the building, I have legendary superstar Shaggy.
Right.
And Bruce Melodie, my special guest too.
Yoo-hoo!
All right, first, Shaggy, let me tell you something. 100 people always come up to me and say, yo, how's your boy Shaggy? I'm saying, my boy Shaggy. I was like, me and Shaggy not really friends like that, you know, but everybody feels so. You know, we have 100 people in common.
We're probably doing just the fact that we're two Jamaican people. So people think that
I know.
They think that every Jamaican know everybody.
That's true. But Sharon Burke is my cousin.
Aye.
Alex Tier gave me my bus in the business.
All right.
First man to hire me to radio.
That two people were close to me. Yes.
Delano. I grew up with Delano.
You know Delano, I'm up to high.
So, yeah, you know, the thing. So,
indeed.
Anyway, man, Dancehall Cyaan Done. I'm really happy to have you guys here. I hear you guys come off a big show a while ago. How was the show?
Oh, we had an amazing time, man. It was a great, great experience. We shelled it. And, of course, we had an opportunity to do a kind of an epic performance of When She's Our Own.
Yes.
With AJR. And Bruce and myself. It's the first time we're all doing it together. AJR, of course, they produced the track.
Okay.
They reproduced the track.
Dope.
And
Because the track, I actually heard a version.
Yeah, it was initially, done by Bruce.
Yeah.
And Bruce released it. How long ago did you release that record?
I released it last year. And the song is called, it's titled Funga Macho.
Funga Macho, yeah.
Right.
Yeah. So we did a remix, and then AGR, they did the music thing, and then Shaggy dropped the verse, and we came up with a huge thing
history.
Like that. Yeah.
You know, it's a feel good record. The first time I heard it, Steve from Esker was in Rwanda, heard the record on the radio.
Oh, wow.
Called me right away and sent it to me and said, Shaggy, you got to listen to this. And I was like, it was in Swahili.
It was in Swahili and Kinyarwanda.
Right, Kinyarwanda, yeah.
Oh, yeah, our mother tongue.
In his native tongue. So right. I couldn't understand anything he was saying. The melody of it and the cadences were amazing. Right. And that saxophone intro was just dope.
Where are you actually from?
Me, I'm from Kigali, Rwanda, East Africa.
There's a Kigali king.
Oh, rotted.
You never go to Rwanda yet?
No.
You're not on a visa?
Yeah. You know, I actually went to a couple places in Africa with Kevin Little and Akon, but, because Kevin Little's DJ. But
okay.
Never Rwanda.
Okay.
Bro, you have to come to Kigali.
I get a crazy story on that, right? I did a concert about 2008.
2008, yeah.
Yeah.
And I played in the stadium down there, right?
Uh-huh.
Massive concert. He was a kid at the time.
Stop it.
He snuck in, watched the whole thing. This was crazy.
Wow.
But by the time I watched him performing, and I was like, I wish one day I can perform in front of these people.
But look at that.
No. Not only me performing in front of that people, I did that.
Yeah.
You know, I celebrated my 10 years career in Kigali, and I filled up the arena, the Kigali arena.
So this guy plays stadiums in East Africa, by the way.
And now,
and with his humility, it's amazing. So
after that, now I did a
song dancing
with him.
The man dancing like a yard man.
I did a record with him, and it's like it feels really, really big to me, because that was my wish. That was my wish, like being like Shaggy, and now I'm sitting with him.
Yeah.
Shaggy, thank you so much for being a big, good person to me.
Oh, good,
and
man.
Thank you much for loving my music, my guy. I appreciate it.
It's funny because I play stadiums too, and I feel the same way with Shaggy, because the last time we were on a show together, it was Fountain Blue.
Oh,
and,
yes.
And you were coming up, and I was like, Shaggy! And you're like, yo, what go on, my dad? But same thing, man. Grew up same way.
It's crazy. You're fun seeing you being a fan of someone else.
Bro, trust me. But humility.
But
you know what I mean?
That's real. That's how we feel.
Facts.
You know.
Facts. So Shaggy, since it's Dancehall Cyaan Done, I want to tell you the joke. This is the first time, because when Cidella wanted me to start the show, she's like, man, GQ, you need some visuals. You need, you know, blah, blah, blah. Because I'm doing it over the phone and, you know, artists come check me, Vegas check me, yeah, whatever. But, you know, this is actually the first one where there's actually going to be footage put out by SiriusXM and Bob Marley Radio. So
congratulations.
Oh, thank you. I'm trying, you know. Yeah. But I have a question for you now, right? Because like me, every time Observer Gleaner do an article about me, them say, Jamaican born, GQ. Now, I actually moved to Jamaica when I was 5. Okay. I was actually born here. Were you born here or were you born in Jamaica?
No, I was born in Jamaica.
Oh, you were actually born in Jamaica.
I lived in Raytown for a little shot, but I was born at St. Andrew Hospital.
Oh, wow. Okay. Because I know you
actually, went to the middle. No, I was born at University Hospital.
Okay.
Right, and then I live at Raytown, CC Charlotte Street.
Wow.
Right. And then we just living at every single tenement you can think of straight when I come to America.
Man.
So
I was in Beverly Hills, so uptown.
I went to 20 Park Primary.
Oh, wow.
And then I go eat it that time with me and Killa and the whole of it.
Nice.
And okay. Then after that, we did Vineyard Town. We used to live at Vineyard Town too. We used to live at Mountain View. We had Waterford.
Damn, you lived a bunch of places, bro.
We used to live at Waterford. I came on as dry right before Third World. That's what I get when we produce Slow Motion with Cartel.
Yeah.
Cartel say, hey, original Gaza.
Because
fame, I was a shoemaker, my uncle was a shoemaker. And him used to do all that Cartel leather work, you know, fixing belt and everything. So that's what I'm going to go buy some for Slow Motion. You see, so me and Cartel are bridging from them times.
Wow.
So yeah, what a place. And then you used to have one boss named Sun Enterprise, so you used to run go back Portmore and come back. And you used to bomb trip and
Portmore must have been brand new.
Yeah, man. You know, over them time, Portsmore never built yet.
Yeah.
Independent City, Waterford.
Yeah.
Brayton. Nagasaki. Them place there. Greater Portmore never exists.
Yeah.
Yeah, see it.
Facts. I remember that.
I used to bomb drive like them peer key and piece out of them part at the time. So I used to run bomb drive from out of Boulevard, go down.
Yeah, man. I remember linking
step out of 3 Mile. I'm broke key in.
Yeah, I remember you used to linking Mad Cabra out there back in the day.
Yeah, man, Cabra all poor boy.
Yeah, for real.
Professor Nuts, I saw the name Love Child.
Love Child.
That time that brother named Lecturer and Professor Lecture, Nuts.
Yeah, man, Lecturer.
Big Lecturer used out the song.
Yeah,
man. First time I see Beanie Man upon that sound of thing.
For real?
Yeah, but I say about 13 years old.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
DJ upon Love Child.
So hold on. So when did you actually get into dancehall? When did you pick up and say, yo, I need to be an artist?
I can tell you what, I see yellow man at Skateland live one time. And like during a week there for school night.
Yeah, way before my time.
I walk, I'm a bridge and walk from over Portmore. But I'm going to tell you something, sir. When we see him, I just know that one.
For real?
So, yeah, a yellow man just DJ 3-2 and I walk out and everybody walk out to him. So from them point there, I really, when we come to America, when we start in Flatbush,
yeah.
Then we start getting to music from in a school, from in a high school. So.
Gotcha.
Used to DJ at the lunchroom and whatever people used to come around and just angry. You know
so, was Old Carolina like your first big hit?
Big global hit. But there were many before, like Big Up, Big Up.
Big Up, yes.
Mumpy, jump on spread out, you know, Mumpy.
Bap.
All Virgin, put up with no one. All Virgin, all them jokes
before. Yeah.
Was before Carolina.
Yeah.
Then we did some other thing like Badger Jet, the Bedrock. Bedwalk, Sensation,
yeah.
Was all part of that whole vibe.
Yeah. I remember listening to Hitman, Colin Hines on radio and him breaking records like that.
Like from back in the days, we all produced those records.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of records that I've written and a lot of records I've produced that you don't know I did.
All right, so
that's that.
You bring that up now, right? Red Fox and Rayvon, how you link up with them on that?
We was all part of one crew. It's called the Rough Entry Crew. And Fox was really kind of the lead of the whole crew because I was in the military at that time.
Right.
So I drive them from North Carolina to New York every weekend, 18 hours back and forth just to do records.
Wow.
Matter of fact, I recorded Old Carolina on Big Up in my military uniform. Go before that, when we reached Flatbush in 1985, 87, 88 around them time there.
Yeah.
Me sell weed. A Brooklyn. Clarkson, Nostrand, a place
called you're the local hooker.
And another one. And then there's some meet Raven too. Raven you took. Raven sent me too.
I believe
I woke up brand name Barry Chad. Barry Chad never stood there. Living room shooter. And then some of me real one the first time.
Oh, but.
But all that we used to do with the crossling in time, man. Back in the day, you know?
Yeah, like every Jamaican come up
for it. You know what I mean? part of the team.
Yeah, man. So, what was like, who was your inspiration, you'd say, like back then, you know, 80s into 90s? Yellow man
from the first, from jump. But after a while, I got into people like Papa San, who was one of my favorite.
Yeah.
So, I was into lyricists at the time. Stitchy, Son, Nuts was one of my favorite. To this day, one of my favorite.
Right.
I was really into people that are very lyrical.
Yeah.
Like Shabba Ranks was a great timing, great album. But whenever I listen to Shabba for lyrics, right. More party records.
Did you ever have beef with an artist? You know, because I mean, come on now, you know, the dancehall thing was
always. There's a lot of artists that have beef with me, but yeah. I don't have beef with them.
Yeah.
They're not in my pay grade to be beef.
Yeah, yeah. No. I hear you. I hear you.
I'm not going to beef with people who's not in my pay grade. You know what I mean? That's not me. No.
So that means nobody can
read. Nah, I can't. I don't have time for that. What am I going to be arguing with somebody that don't have visas?
Yeah.
Like, really? You know what I mean? Like, come on, stop.
Oh, my God. Well, okay, so when did you realize, like, that you just made it? Like, when was the first time, whether you heard your song on radio or something, you're like, yo, like, this is it?
I never thought I made it. To be honest with you, I still haven't made it.
That's deep.
Because we're in a genre of dancehall that even when you go as far as this, we're not a movement.
Yeah.
And I mean, when you look at what the Latin people have done, they got their own Grammys and all, and you look at the streaming numbers, we have not made it. I have just contributed to something and we go close and not gone.
Yeah.
You know I mean, to this day, there's no way that me and Sean Paul should be the top streaming guys in the genre.
Yeah. You're right.
These younger guys should have been out streaming us already. In every other genre, other young people are.
So as you bring that up now, what do you feel about dancehall now?
I feel good about it because this year has been a good year. We have Byron Messiah and
right.
TJ. I was very heavily involved with the TJ part.
Right, right. Sharon.
And exactly. And yeah. And you know, helping to get TJ signed and I'm executive producing TJ's album. And you know I mean? He brought Drift to me, I was like, yeah, let's go with it. You know what I mean? So
big.
I was a part of all of that, but I'm hoping to see bigger things with that. So I'm optimistic, but you know, cause we're just maintaining me right now.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? If I'm on camp, my someone I said, yo, you're shocking if you live with the team right now. I said, take me out.
Yeah. I know. I
hear take me out.
Because, you know, funny, a lot of people tell me that about Vegas. So they're like, yo, tell your boy for the skis off, no man, and forget it.
What?
I know.
That one I named foot in a neck.
Yeah.
You better take me out.
Yeah.
I'm going to make it hard for you too. Because that's what the game is.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. So how you two met now?
We just met.
I don't know if you're telling me the truth or not.
Nah, a couple weeks ago.
We're telling you the truth.
This is his first trip right now in Miami.
In Miami, yeah.
Stop it.
Yeah.
So you two genuinely just met.
We met from Zoom before.
Yeah. But personally.
Yeah, personally.
Oh, Rod is good.
Yeah.
And the records are big. I feel like you two mesh. Like you were friends for like 5 years or something.
Nah, you know the story. The first time I met him in we had dinner the first night in Dallas.
Yeah.
Wow. And it just clicked. I was really moved on his humility. Because like I said, this guy is huge in East Africa.
Right.
This guy.
I saw, because even the original record had a couple million views on it.
Massive.
Like literally today.
But his humility really moved me.
Mm.
You know, because you have someone in Jamaica we had a record with, and them might have been up. Them are both like wedding wins there. and the ego on them is
huge.
Yeah. Whoa. Them doing a visa.
Facts.
And the ego. I mean, I might do a record. I can't even get them on the, you know what I mean? It's like, yeah. But this kid is, as big as he is, he's humble.
Yeah.
He's appreciative. He's a hard worker. He shows up on time. He does great interviews. He's on it. And he's professional. And nice. I like working with professional people.
All right.
So I didn't tell this to Shaggy, but I'm a big fan to the extent that I heard his record with this other guy from Jamaica. I don't really remember the name of the
Which
guy.
Which Godong there?
No. Which it's one? You just were trying to show off your country.
Yeah. Sweet Jamaica?
Yeah. That song to the label. I'm trying to do the same to my country.
Yeah.
You know, I love that song.
Sweet Jamaica. I love it.
If you like Jamaica, let me see your hands. I want to do that to my country. So yeah. I learned a lot about Shaggy before even meeting him in person.
Wow.
And after I met him in person, I realized that he's even more a good person than what I've just seen in him. So I feel like I'm living my dreams. As I told you, I went to his concert, and I didn't have money for the ticket and all that. But even right now, I'm still so surprised to do all this with this guy. Hands up.
So, question now: What else in dancehall inspired you? Like, because I feel it in your song. So,
look at this. Me, I used to be a producer. Back in Kigali, we have some dancehall artists. So I used to produce for them. That's why even when you're speaking Patois, I can pick some. I know that when you want to say two, you say three. So I get it, and I love dancehall because it's very, very close to Afrobeat, and that's what we're doing right now.
Yeah.
So it's very, very easy for me and Shaggy to connect because he brings these vibes of dancehall, and
just,
I have this Afrobeat
vibes.
Yeah.
MC, keep it global, not local.
Yeah, facts. All right. So what's next for Shaggy? Because I know you're big into the philanthropy thing, you're big into the music, you're re.
Yeah, I'm on to some other things that's inspire. I do whatever inspires me. So, you know, Sting and I have been doing a lot of work, and that inspires me.
So
we just launched our One Fine Day Festival last year.
Nice.
Earlier this year in September, which was massive turnout. We're doing it again next year.
Nice.
So I'm looking forward to that. There's a summer tour that we have planned. I'm looking forward to promoting this song on a global scale.
Okay.
We just got NRJ, which is a massive look. NRJ is like almost like iHeart, but in France.
Okay.
It's a massive ad for us, and you know, they're really the Shazam on the numbers on this record looks good. So I'm really excited and really looking forward to actually promoting that. And I got some other records that I got. I got a record with me and Akon and Idonia that rolled up. I got some with me and Maya and Olaf. I got coming out. I got a whole bunch of people.
Hold on. Rob Banks.
Yeah.
I cannot believe Rob Banks is your son. You know,
I'm
a Broward man.
So,
you know, when I heard Rob Banks at first, I was like, yo, this dude is dope. And then a man came to me and said, yo, you know, say a Shaggy son.
Yeah.
I was like,
I tell you a crazy thing. I remember one day coming into his mom's house, right? So I'm coming over to the house, and I walked up in the driveway, and this kid had, like, he had on some, like, he was just in his drawers and a flip flop. So I said, yo, where your pants at? You know?
Yeah.
And he just laughed or whatever. I said, yo, go get some pants, man. You know, walk in. And my son looked at me afterwards and said, you remember that kid that you told that? Yeah. By the way, that was X.
Yeah. Oh,
and it was Existential.
Yeah.
So all those kids used to be, you know, when you look at Ed Click, Ski Mask.
Yep.
All those kids. Matter of fact, Matt and Tariq, that does Rolling
Rock. Yeah.
They were his tour managers when they started. So all these kids are kids that really was really cool. In my driveway at my house back then that are now massive rappers.
Crazy.
From Broward.
Broward.
You know what I mean? That I've done. So it's just amazing. I mean, you know, Rob does his thing, man, and he's you know, he's at the studio every night.
Yeah.
You know, over at the house every night, just doing as much stuff as possible, putting things out, touring.
So what do you say? A combo? Shaggy, Rob?
We have many records again. Yeah? We just haven't put any out.
Nice.
But we collaborate all the time. We just have not released anything.
So, okay, okay. So, yeah, well, obviously on this show, I'm going to be playing the joint, you know. So, what else new from...
Oh, he's got a record doing. He's doing an album.
Yeah?
Yeah. I'm working on my album.
Okay, good.
Which is coming out next year.
Okay.
So, you should expect more than this we have right now. But
good.
You guys have to enjoy this when she's around. It's a happy song. It's an alpha beat with dancehall.
Facts.
There's AG around the song.
Yeah.
So, we want you to enjoy this, but meanwhile we are working on some other good stuff. Like for me, I'm working on my album, and my the song I prefer on my album is titled Soweto. Have you heard about Soweto?
Yeah.
It's a place.
South Africa, right?
Yeah. It's in South Africa. So yeah.
Global. But I just bad with Africa.
The visa thing. The visa.
Do you know what they say about Shaggy in my country?
Oh, he's a guy.
When you put up with a lot of girls,
yeah,
they say you look like Shaggy.
It wasn't me. Yo, God bless you. Yo, tell the people where them can find you, Bruce Melodie.
I'm everywhere. I'm Bruce Melodie, that's my name. And my tag is Yoo-hoo. Whenever I hear that.
What's your Instagram?
Bruce Melodie on Instagram.
Yeah.
Bruce Melodie on Twitter. Bruce Melodie everywhere. Any social media, any digital platform you use.
Nice.
That's how you found Bruce Melodie.
Cool. Tell them Shaggy.
Yeah. You can find Shaggy at any strip chat now.
At the real Shaggy on Instagram, Facebook, and on Twitter or X now.
Yeah.
And / Shaggy on Facebook. So it's great. All right. Cool breeze. All right, guys. Yo, thanks a million.
Yo, this is Shaggy.
Bruce Melodie.
I want you to check out our new single when she's around on Bob Marley's Tuff Gong Radio right here on SiriusXM.
Yoo-hoo.